Good morning. Over these past couple of weeks, I've been getting a lot of questions about what I do on a day-to-day basis while I'm out here in college from both friends and family. And as I was thinking about it, I realized this would make a really interesting video. Welcome to A Day in the Life of a Furman University Student. So now, before I start diving into what I do on a daily basis, I think it'd be good to give you a little bit of background as to who I am and what I do. My name is Oscar, and I am a documented senior here at Furman, majoring in Asian studies and taking a lot of language classes at the moment. But just to give you a quick background here, I was born in Honduras. Both my mom's side of my family and I were all immigrants from Honduras, and I've been living here in Greenville, South Carolina, ever since I was about four and a half years old. And so, because I've been living in the United States for such a long time, I'm fortunate enough to have learned English at a very young age going through elementary school. And because I speak Spanish at my house, también sé cómo hablar español. And on top of that, these past 3 years, I've been studying Japanese. だから僕は今、日本語も話せるよ。On top of that, last summer, I set a goal for myself to become conversationally fluent in French in 6 months. Et puis, je crois que je peux parler en français avec les personnes. Et je suis désolé, mais mon français n'est pas très bien. それに、僕の日本語は上手じゃないんです、本当に。And lastly, this semester, I started taking Italian as well. Ma, io non capisco molto bene l'italiano, ma posso parlare con I gente un po'. And hey, if anyone out there is interested in practicing foreign languages with me, then feel free to reach out to me on Tandem. My username will be down in the description below. Okay, so now that we have the introduction out of the way, let's just jump right into what I do on a typical Monday here. So for give or take about a year now, one of the things I've been doing consistently each and every morning has been reading the Wall Street Journal and the New York Times. I think it's very important to stay up to date with world events, and so that's one of the things that I typically like to do first thing in the morning. Now with my morning news readings out of the way, the next thing I typically like to jump right into is working out. So about a year ago, I set a personal goal for myself to run at the very least 3 times a week. And just on a personal note, running is really one of those things that's really gotten me into the habit of consistently setting goals for myself and trying to become better and better each and every day. So when I first started about a year ago, I could barely run 2 miles consistently. And just 2 days ago, I ran my first half marathon. With that said, I think it's about time to head to the gym. The thing I really enjoy doing when I'm out working out or out at the gym or out and about is just getting a few more minutes in on my audiobook so that I can meet my goal of 24 books by the end of this year. If you're wondering what it is I'm listening to, recently I started listening to this audiobook called The Founders by Jimmy Soni. Yeah, so it's a little bit past 7 a.m. out here on campus, and you probably have seen there's not a whole lot of activity out here this early in the morning, but I'm sure as the day progresses, there's definitely going to be a whole lot more people out here. There's the gym. Finally made my way back from the gym, did a nice upper body workout there for about an hour, but I guess for now it's time to take a quick shower, and after that we're gonna go grab some breakfast. Okay, Mr. Editor, on the count of three, make it look like I just took a shower. 1, 2, 3. And let's go get some breakfast. So I just got back from breakfast here and I wanted to really quickly fill you in on what classes I'm going to be taking throughout the day. So like I said before, today is a Monday, and the reason I wanted to film this video on a Monday was because Mondays are typically my language heavy days. So at 9:30, so in about 15 minutes from now, I'm gonna be in my French class, and then right after that, at 10:30, I'm gonna be working as a TA for the introductory Japanese class here on campus. And immediately after that, I'm gonna do another section of that, so that'll be for about 2 hours. So that brings me to around 12:30 p.m. and at around that time, I'm gonna be in the Café Français language group. So for about an hour, I'm gonna be basically talking, conversing, asking questions, and getting to know other French students. And immediately after that, at 1:30 p.m., I'm gonna be in my Italian class. All right, with all that said, I have about 5 minutes until my class gets started. So I'm gonna make my way over to French here real quick, and I'll catch you all on the flip side. Alright everyone, so I just got back from my Café Français event, and I gotta say this one was pretty special because in celebration of Mardi Gras, they decided that they were gonna give us all a bunch of king's cake. So that was really cool. Getting ready to head over to my Italian class right now, where we're gonna be cooking a bunch of food in celebration of Mardi Gras. I'll be sure to keep you all posted and see how that goes. Alright, let's head over there. Just got back from Italian class here, and I had the pleasure of making some ghiacchiere di carnevale, almost like funnel cake, but just a little bit zestier, has a stronger lemony taste. It's really fantastic what we made there. But that said, it's time to move on to band. Let's get ready for that. And for those of you who are curious, I play the trombone in band. I've been playing it ever since I was around 11 years old, 22 now, so I've been playing this instrument for over a decade now. It's crazy to think about, but I absolutely love playing this instrument. I love being a part of the band program here at school. And yeah, let's go ahead and play a few notes right before I have to head off to rehearsal later on. And yeah, don't worry, I'll spare you having to listen to me practice for today. But when we come back, it's gonna be after band practice, and I'll let you know how it goes. Man, today has been a pretty hectic day with everything I had going on. It is now approximately 6 p.m. So at this point, what I'm gonna do is just decompress a little bit, take in everything that happened today, do a bit of reflecting, and get ready to head on over to dinner at the dining hall. Okay, it is now 8 o'clock at night, and I am absolutely tired right now. I am super worn out. As you can see, it's not uncommon for me on a daily basis to use up to 5 different languages between my different classes and just talking to friends and everything else I have going on. 6, I guess, if you include music there. So today I had French, Japanese, and Italian class just back to back. While it's super fun tonight, that leaves me with quite a bit of homework to get ready for the next day. A history essay that I'm currently working on for a really interesting class I'm taking right now on Mao Zedong. And in addition to that, I also have to finish reading a couple of articles for my Chinese politics course for tomorrow. Being an Asian studies major myself, I was really interested in taking more classes that focus specifically on China. And that's why I find this politics and history class that I'm currently taking right now to be so fascinating. Now, with all of that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the work that I have to get ready for tomorrow since it's starting to get pretty late. And finally, as a few final parting notes here, if you have any sort of questions for me, please feel free to leave them down below in the comments section, or if you want to get in touch with me directly, you can find my Twitter handle down below. Feel free to reach out to me. Now, with all that being said, arigatou gozaimashita, grazie mille, muchas gracias, merci beaucoup, thank you very, very much for taking the time to watch this video. Catch you later.